and welcome to Ask Me Doctor Season 2, a video series for you parents to learn more about your children's health. I'm Hazel from motherhood.com.my. In the previous season, we have cleared up some misconceptions during pregnancy. This time round, we're gonna debunk more myths, but we'll focus on children's health. I'm pretty sure every one of you have heard of this. Sugar causes our children to be hyperactive. Am I right? But is that true? Today, we are very fortunate to have Dr. Fu, pediatrician from Dr. Fu Child Specialist Clinic, to help us to dispel 10 common myths that you have submitted earlier on our Facebook. Hello, Dr. Fu.
Hi, Hazel.
Right, let's dive right into our first question. Using baby talk with an infant delays their ability to speak normally. Is that true, Dr. Fu?
Not entirely true. We can't say that baby talk would delay the speech development of a child. But we have to define what exactly is baby talk, yeah? I think baby talk is a good kickstarter for a child to learn language, to introduce them to the world of sounds and speech. But baby talk should not be just about meaningless babbling gibberish words like gugu gaga, ooh, but if you define baby talk as actually a parent using a very animated style of talking to the child, using high-pitched voice to make it more exciting in a more dramatic way, in an exaggerated manner with lots of facial expression to speak in a very interesting way to engage fully with the child, that kind of speech is actually very useful to help the child to develop their own speech.
Number two, antibiotic is the key to many illness, especially fever and cold.
No, not true at all. I think antibiotics has been abused. First of all, we need to differentiate between viral illnesses and bacterial illnesses. Virus and bacteria, both are germs, both are pathogens, but they are really, really different entity. When we talk about antibiotics is a medication that is only to treat bacterial infection. So when you talk about fever and cough, right, most of the time, especially in the childhood period, a child with fever and cough and cold, runny nose, high chance that it's actually due to a viral infection. Now, if it's a viral infection, it is actually a waste of money and resources and to give antibiotics, like you give it a false sense of security that you are doing something for the infection. In fact, antibiotics may actually lead to other side effects. It increases the chance for antibiotic resistance, it can lead to a bad diarrhea, so it causes problem unnecessarily. So I do not agree that a child with fever, cough, runny nose should be routinely be given antibiotics. Huh? Instead, antibiotics should be used for obvious significant bacterial infection. So if a child is having a ear infection, a tonsil infection, or a lung infection, a urinary tract infection, or a skin infection from an infected wound, those kind of conditions, you need antibiotics. Yeah.
Thank you very much, Dr. Fu. So it's not all illness that you will need antibiotic to cure. Number three, sugar intake causes our children to be hyperactive.
This one is can be a controversial topic because I think even the earlier studies, they have hypothesized that sugar may cause a hyperactive behavior. But further studies have shown that actually, even in children who takes a sugar intake that is much higher than the WHO recommendation, they are found not to have an increased risk to develop ADHD, which is attention deficit hyperactive disorder. However, high sugar intake can cause body physiological changes. It gives you an adrenaline rush. So it will lead to the person may develop symptoms and behavior that is like similar to being hyperactive because of the adrenaline rush, right? If you are stating that sugar has a direct link to hyperactive disorder, then it is not true. However, it is never good to give too much sugar to your child. We must always emphasize that a child must have a healthy diet. Simple sugar, too much of refined sugar is never good anyway. Yeah, so it's good to have a healthy diet.
So we can say that sugar causes sugar rush, but it's not the same that is causing hyperactive.
Yes, yes, yes. If you're taking high sugar intake, yeah, like you could call it a sugar rush and adrenaline, increased adrenaline response because your sudden increase in the blood sugar activity will have these kind of symptoms. But just because of that, do not make the child have a disorder, increase risk to be a, to have ADHD.
So talking about sugar, sweets, one of our parents' favorite is giving our children ice cream. Yeah. So question number four, eating ice cream will lead to cough.
While I always recommend parents not to give too much sugar to the children, I would like to confess that my daughter and I enjoy ice cream quite regularly. Thankfully, both of us never had any cough just because of taking ice cream. Now, again, there is no direct link between just merely ice cream and you will surely get a cough. There are people who get cough or they become uncomfortable in their throat, in their breathing after taking ice cream. Now, these are mainly because of allergy. If you are allergic to certain substance or ingredient from the ice cream, like dairy products or those artificial flavoring or coloring, any additives inside, so it can cause a discomfort of the throat or maybe even the airway and lead you to having a cough, lah. But yeah, again, not everyone who enjoys an ice cream will end up having a cough. And it's I would like to emphasize that there are no, I mean, provided that the food safety procedures are all done, your ice cream do not contain any bacteria or germs where you will get fever just by, you know, ingesting the ice cream. Okay, a lot of parents would say that, oh, you see, yesterday had some ice cream and a lot of sweets and candy, say today fever already and start coughing. It's most likely this is not true.
On the next question is for growing up children. Teething causes fever, is that right?
Teething causing fever, yeah, this is a very, this one I have to explain a bit longer because there are a lot of caveats. First of all, teething does make a child to be fussy, to feel uneasy. They may even, their body may feel a bit even warmer, but it is not a true fever. The teething would start happening between 6 to 8 months. And also around this time, it is also a very common period for your baby to start really falling sick significantly for the first time, meaning they really have a fever. Usually they are having a mild viral fever known as Rosella infantum. So there is a, like these two events are overlapping, and this is, which is why like parents and our grandparents tend to blame teething on fever. Now it is a bit dangerous to just blame teething causing fever, because then we may end up delaying action treating the fever. When a child is really significantly unwell because of fever, lose appetite and start to have fever, cough and cold, you cannot just blame it on teething. What is more likely is that during this period, right, because your child is growing, teething experience, all these are stressful factors. All these growing up, your immune system occasionally may get weakened for a while and allow those previous viruses that are already exposed get activated and give you a mild viral infection. So the common infection in a child, in an infant between 6 months old all the way to 2 years old would be Rosella infantum, you know, 3 to 5 days of intermittent fever up and down. And towards the end, your child will have a recovery rashes. So that is definitely not due to teething. Yeah, when your child is having a significant fever, you have to think of infection, either bacterial or viral, but even that also, it most likely it is a mild infection only. Yeah, so you cannot blame teething, because sometimes it gives you a sense of false security and may end up in delayed action.
For more videos about our children's health, stay tuned for our upcoming videos on Ask Me Doctor. I'm Hazel.
I'm Dr. Fu.
This is motherhood.com.my.